Well, we're back. I'm day two of this rock crawling road trip. We're at Reader OHV today, doing the thing. Same guys from yesterday. If you missed out on yesterday, go check out last week's video. We went into this rock fall, some of the craziest wheeling I've ever been a part of. But we're at Reader, so we're gonna go do the thing in the woods on the rocks here. We gotta hit up God Rock, we gotta hit up Candy Corn, and who knows what else. But we have a big group of buggies today. Whole bunch of guys I've never wheeled before, and old man Cobb. We love old man Cobb. He's on day three with his brand new bomber. So good times. I'm gonna shut up and let's get doing some wheeling. Gotta warm them tires up a little bit.
Go, go!
Yeah!
You don't need a spotter. Oh. Cool.
Low drop.
There you go.
This man impressed the hell out of me yesterday, doing things that a Toyota really shouldn't do.
A Toyota.
It's got Toyota T cases. Okay, so Cobb just finished building this thing. This is, he said this is his third day in it. It's a bomber chassis. And he's running Jesse Haynes fab portal axles, spider track stuff. Cobb built nice rigs. And also, take note of his hilarious steering wheel. We were already teasing him with his bus driver steering. This is literal shakedown buggy, or shakedown run in this thing. Cobb just finished here, so we're ironing out the kinks a little bit. He said yesterday he got down and realized his front drive line was all completely loose. So sometimes it'd be like that. And mine is here. We got Tristan's girlfriend driving his Toyota today, and he's standing out there giving bad advice. He's just gonna yell advice to the girlfriend all day. So they're gonna have a domestic in a little bit. She drives better than you do, Tristan.
All the way passengers. Anybody know who this is? Probably not. They were so
also, I didn't give you nearly a hard enough time yesterday about the fact that you're like the only man on the planet with spider nines and leaf springs. For those of you guys who don't know, that is like $10,000 axle on leaf springs. It's fine. I love it. Leaf springs are good, okay? You hear me clicking away. I'm rocking the fancy camera today. So that's me being Larry Chen in the background, snapping stills, but then also burning on the video. It's too many things for my stupid brain. Okay, this is a real easy warm-up trail, and then we're gonna head up the hills and do some much harder stuff because we're not here for easy. Oh, breakfast bush lattes.
Absolutely.
It's the breakfast of champions right there. I believe he's a 4.3 liter and he's Toyota T cases. Dana 60 in the front, 14 volt steering in the rear. And I'm probably gonna get some of these details wrong, but we all know I'm just making it all up as we go anyways. So we did a real half-assed look over Walker's rig last night. And it looked like the only thing that was a problem from yesterday was a couple loose bolts in his front diff cover. So we were leaking a little bit of gear oil, tighten that up, and she's mint. Oh, it's muddy.
I know.
Who said there was gonna be mud? Nice. Whatever, you got the best tires for mud anyways. The 43-inch super swampers. Yeah, brand new portal axles, so you can see. He's got the gears and the hubs, which brings the driveline up. He's got huge diff clearance. all the cool kids these days, all the fancy cars are going into portals. Oh, that's one way of doing it. New car blues. Steering freaking hose loosened off. Sprayed.
Dropped on the head.
Yep. This one.
No more source.
Loose.
Burn off.
Yeah.
And it was just one big poof.
You shouldn't be able to turn that by hand. All right, as we get further up the hill, the rocks getting bigger. I just walked past a sign that said Boulder Alley. So that's the trail we're on here. And I think we're going up to God Rock right now, which is good times. Got it. Nice driving. Look at that link. He said it was straight before we started the day yesterday. He thundered his 200 links. I was telling him that's why we rocked the Island Spec square tube links, because they're harder to bend and they're cheaper to replace. So it might look like an Island Spec leaf spring Toyota, but there's an Atlas under there, as well as the Spider 9s. Oh, and he's doing it. Nice moves. Yeah. Nitto's climbing better than the BFGs there. We don't see too many Nittos up island ways. So cool to see something different. We collected a few more buddies from the parking lot. And now we're gonna head up this trail. For those of you who know what God Rock is, giddy up. For those of you who don't, you'll see. It's good times. And well, what's God Rock? That's God Rock. So we're a good 15 feet above the forest floor, and they're gonna drive right up there. So it's not the hardest thing out here, but it's definitely one of the most intimidating things out here. So let's do stupid things with our friends. The tire's looking soft. He's barely running 15 PSI, for those of you guys who say, he's running too much air pressure. Why? Because those are brand new Reds, and he doesn't want as much traction as you think, because he's worried about blowing up his Toyota T-cases. That's right. That man's running dual Toyota T-cases. Camera never does justice, but keep in mind, like that's a four-seater Toyota on 40-inch tires that we're talking about. And that little toy-like person over there, it's Tristan. So that's how big that rock is. Clever move of Purdue here, getting to the front of the line, because the rocks are as dry and as clean as they get. You're doing it! That's silly. Ah, I love my job! Do it! That tire right now is 8 feet from the ground down here. If I stood down there, I don't think I could reach up and touch that tire right now. He's doing it. Yes! That's wild. See, it's not that hard of an obstacle, except for the fact that if you roll when you're up there, if you screw up, you got 10 feet to the rocks. But he's gonna keep working in here, and he's gonna make it. He needs to cut the rear this way. We don't get her. See that driver's front lifting up, getting a little light. That's better. Oh, look at this guy giving instructions. You're okay. You're doing it. I don't want to stand over there. He's winning though. So yeah. If you think you wheel big obstacles, well, send me some pics, send me some videos, and show me what you guys are wheeling, because this is what we do on Sundays. There she be. You did it! So I don't know if you let some air out or it burped some air out, but it's probably at like 6 or 7 now. Exactly. It's right in the sweet spot. Part of this problem is those are brand spanking new BFGs, 3 days old, so they're not really broken in yet. so they don't squat that much. You need to run them at low pressure and have them loosen up a bit. Cool. He's licked the hard part. Oh, he's going right off the corner, eh? Steve Cobb don't care. Just slide those expensive parts over the edge. There it is. Cool. You see I'm standing at the bottom now. Last two rigs I was up there with Purdue, so trying to give you an idea of how big this damn obstacle is. And well, when you see a drag axle Toyota on there on leaf springs, Nitto trail grapplers, they're showing off some damn good traction. In some ways they're putting the reds to shame today. See, the thing is, if Tristan does this right now on leaf springs, he gets the ultimate bragging rights over all the other guys, because, you know, if you did it in four-wheel car, four-steer, that's one thing, but if you're doing a leaf sprung Toyota, wow, that's something else. That back tire climbs, he's doing it. Damn, wow, he just did it easier than Cobb in his fancy bomber car. If you're not trash talking all day, then are you really wheeling right? Oh, you dicked her there, bud. Gonna find out how good the sidewalls are. Nice, well played. So this is another S&N chassis. So this would be the exact same as Walker's chassis, same as Doug's chassis. This is another four-steer one. But apparently over the channel the last few weeks, we've been highlighting the S&N fab buggies. You don't need a spotter. Good looking line, you're winning. So it's one thing to drive up that with a man telling you every move to make. It's another to just be doing it yourself. I believe Paulie's driven up this thing countless times. So he doesn't need a spotter. Pretty close though, as long as that rear end comes up. He's got her. Right on. Well then, welcome to God Rock. We're gonna head up the hill now. Probably gonna hit up Candy Corn.
Oh, it's happening.
I'm doing great. How you doing?
Right on. Right on.
Well then, now it's just a parking lot up here. Uh-oh. I ran out of throttle. Your Coors Light can is leaking. It's probably because it's Coors Light.
Better than Bud Light.
We're moving onwards and upwards. So these are more of these man-made obstacles. All these rocks are placed in here. But when you mix the placed rocks with those big natural rocks, well, you end up with a reeder. This is cool stuff. Not such easy walking. Oh, that big gash in Purdue's back tire just opened up. He's been obsessing over that since yesterday, since I showed him that. It's a brand new Reds, so that sidewall gash down to the cords kind of sucks. Ooh, ah. You're right into this tree. You gotta turn. Or just push it out of the way. That also works. Well, it wasn't pretty. Oh. Oh. So all the fun sounds like it's happening on that side. Yes. That looking good. Nicely done. You're gonna end up in this tree. Oh, let's watch. Oh, he's gonna miss the door panel. I missed it! Ah, oh, I was just really hoping you were gonna put a nice big dent there. Oh, you got all that diff clearance that Walker doesn't have. He paid big dollars for. Nice. Cool thing with this like slow precise wheeling is I can be right here. Like, look, that's how close I am. Camera never makes it look like that, but. So I'm just standing here chowing exhaust all day. Nice. Just wedge her in there. Now you're out. Mint. I laugh every time I see this gash open up. Right across the TA right there. It's running, he runs an Only Dad's channel.
Only Dad's?
Exactly.
That's how we built all these.
Exactly. It's like $8 for butthole pics. Not that I know or anything. I'm a subscriber. $12, you get to see his taint. I think you just gotta come this way in the front and get over that rock. Like that. Now hard that way. But don't listen to me. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm just a camera guy. Advice! That'll work.
There it is.
There you go. Got her that time. Oh, he's doing it. Damn.
I drive the Sam Ram.
Damn. You know it's slippery when his tires are moving forwards and he's just sliding backwards. Got it.
Yeah, that sounds like it runs pretty good.
Exactly, compared to where I'm from.
That's like
sounds like a race car, exactly. It's nice as it gets.
Oh,
that is a good looking line. Well, that's a cool alternate line. Here we are blabbing. Well, Paulie's making it work on the stump side. Oh no. Oh no. I'm making a cringy face. Oh no! Oh, that back tire, holy sh!
He just wants
to
party.
Wow! That red is really holding up for you. Wow! Everybody behind the camera is cringing.
Exactly right.
Making scared faces. Wow. I'm really impressed with that tire.
Yeah, no kidding.
Talk about having stout drivetrain. That was as bound up as you can get a tire. Harry's got it this time, I think. Yep. Well then. Rear steer is awesome. So we're crab walking our way down to Candy Corn. We're gonna hit that up. This is the infamous Candy Corn obstacle. If you've seen any of my other reader videos, we always end up doing this one. This is one of the hardest obstacles around. It's intimidating. Cause you're 20 feet up there. There's not much room. So Steve Cobb spent about 20 minutes slowly trying to work his way up there. But you'll see all the water on the rocks. He started pushing coolant. It was getting a bit hot. If he had water in his front tires, probably would have done it no problem, but it was getting a little light in the front. So Polly's gonna give her a go here. Yeah. Steve Cobb saying it's first time he's been denied on driving up there. That's a winner winner right there. He did the hard part. Said, I don't know how to get down from here. Gravity does most of the getting down.
Molly, you ready to go?
Yep.
Good.
Bring your rear towards me a little. Right now, your front. Yep.
Oh! Saved it. Damn, son.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice dismount. He scared me, I ran out of the way. Took Polly at least 15 minutes of jiggling around and get her to work. But Purdue's ready to rock it. He's tried this multiple times and apparently has been denied every time. But confidence is high today. He just got to watch Polly do it, so do the thing. Look how much rubber you guys sloughed off down in the moss there. It's all black. Exactly. Yeah. He's so close, but he's also not.
He's so close.
Everyone's backed up now.
So close both ways.
Yeah, exactly. He's so close to making it and so close to rolling. Need to warm him up a little bit. See if we can make him a little stickier. Well, right on. Hey, you don't need seatbelts anymore. Yeah. You've done the hard stuff.
Dude, you can walk.
Time for a bush latte and no seatbelts. Did some candy corn action. Now we're heading off to the Devil's Staircase. I've only been on this one once, and these guys hate it because it's all man-made, and it's hard. Walker already walkered right up this. Goddamn Nitto tires. Gotta say, I've been impressed as hell with those Nittos today.
Say, those Nittos were a good purchase. They're hooking them way better than the Reds.
I think they are. Don't put that on camera, though. I look like an idiot.
No, we have to put that on camera. Just a shame all the guys with Reds. Nittos are the new Reds. Heard it here first. Send me angry comments and tell me I'm wrong. The hell do I know? I run IROX.
This has got to be a good trail. Because both Purdue and Tristan keep telling me how terrible it is and how much I hate it. So that's a good sign. It's just boulders in the woods. This is more of the, what do they call it? Man-made trails. Durr. Why we complain about that is like boulders like this are super unforgiving because they got real sharp edges. So you get caught on them, you bang down real hard and they move a little bit. So it's an effort. But Tristan here is gonna leaf spring it up. Team leaf spring. Well, these guys might hate this trail, but it sure looks pretty cool in the forest, I guess. This is why we need some boulders up at my place. That's an unforgiving hole. Hey-o. Walker's making real good time here. Oh yeah, these rocks are a little wider space, they're a little more forgiving. Guys complaining about this trail being so hard, they hate it so much, they sure are working their way through it so pretty easily. And well, we started the day with a pretty big group, we're down to three, but we're having fun. Oh, look at those Nittos hook up. Oh. Hula Girl, that's an important add-on. So somebody sent me a message earlier, was asking me about editing these videos, and they're like, oh, how long does it take you to edit one of these videos? I don't know, 2-3 hours? I wish. Pretty much, the amount of time I have to spend in the editing room is about double the amount of time I have to spend on the trail. So over this weekend, we'll do probably 30 hours of filming, do 3 videos, and I'm gonna be probably 60 hours worth of editing to, get these videos out for you guys. So now I don't mind doing it, but it's a long and pain in the ass process to lay all these tracks down. So I wish that I could do it in 2 hours. But unfortunately, I'm not very good at editing video. This takes a long time. It's a good looking trail. This would be really hard on not sticky tires. Normal tires, normies. These are some sweet rocks. That's a lot of work to move this many rocks around in the woods. I don't care how big your excavator is. Some of these are some serious slabs. So good job on Scotty, who did all the work here at Reeder to make these trails. All the work. I don't want to discount anything that anybody else did. He's just the man that I know that was driving the excavator and did a lot of this moving around. Well, this is awesome times here. So this is Sunday, day two, being down in America for some rock crawling. We're heading out again tomorrow to meet up with these usual suspects. And we got a whole new set of trails to run. And I can't wait. Not here, new place. So we'll get to it. Man. These guys really love their front dig. They're making me think that maybe I should be using my front dig more often. I don't get much use out of it because I don't find it all that helpful. But I also don't really crawl it. I kind of drive like an idiot. In fact, I drive like a professional idiot. Some technical crawling in these rocks. And if you've ever wondered why our rigs all look so beat to hell, well, if you watch this, it's pretty self-explanatory. It's easy to slide off stuff, it's easy to smash into stuff. And they take a beating out here. That's the way. Gonna scrubber up that tree. That's the way for sure. You might have made it up high enough. Keep going, you got her. Damn. I just can't believe the binding that these rigs take and still be okay. It's wild. Nice. Open that back end, you're sliding that rock. That's what we need. There she goes.
Oh my god.
Nice. Ugh. Leaf string life. Too easy. I think this trail is called Kaboom. I haven't been on this one. Oh, I've been chowing exhaust all day. Starting to get to me. Sick Jeep, bro. Eight turns, lock to lock. I need a couple more turns in your steering wheel. A couple more turns, lock to lock.
Eight isn't enough.
Eight is not enough. Just traction. This is an obstacle they call Little Candy Corn. You'll see why when I go around to the other side, because it drops down. But we gotta start over here. We'll work our way around. But it's a bit of a beauty drop going down the other side. Look how gummy that driver's rear tire looks.
Yeah. Look at that, holy. Little more, right there. Little drop.
Oh, ouch.
The rock move.
Yeah, he's moving the one on the right. Ouch, that probably hurt. His pride and his butthole.
You calling it?
Did you move?
Don't worry, a substantially less capable truck is gonna do it now. Huh? Oh yeah, that link is extra bendy now. Well yeah, ooh, you should look at your drive shaft. It's not buggered, but you definitely scarfed a bit of paint off your, a bit of the steel off your drive shaft. Walker wasn't gonna do this climb, and then he watched Tristan just stomp it, so now he has to do it. As soon as Tristan did it, it wasn't a question of if he was gonna do it or not. It's like, you have to do it now. You don't even have an option.
All passenger right now. All passenger? All passenger. Right there.
All way passenger. Oh, belt's going on. It's getting serious. Oh, trail dad's getting out. It's getting real serious. That's a sign. So the peak there is probably a good 8 feet. This side's about 6 feet. And yeah, he's just gonna make it happen. Son, well done. Well, Tristan just decided that he had to turn around and drop it right back down off this thing, so he's gonna get that done. Yeehaw.
That's a party.
That was a party line. Well, you know, it's the end of a long day when we're back in the parking lot doing stupid stuff like this. Your day of jeeping, you gotta do some jeep poses. It's gonna look so cool on the internet though. That's it. Long day of rock crawling at Reeder. But we're gonna load up and go hit up the barbecue joint down the street. And then we're gonna get ready tomorrow for another day of rock crawling. Now, I'm not gonna tell you where we're going tomorrow, but it's gonna be good. It's gonna be a little bit of tree wheeling, like I love. Anyways, boys, everyone, have a good one. Stay tuned next week. Cheers.